Dear students, welcome and thank you for tuning in to this video. We are still talking about diffusion. This is the third video of a series I'm making about diffusion in metals and solids. This is part of the biomaterials class. This video, actually, we're going to be talking about two different mechanisms that diffusion happen in solids. The first mechanism is something called vacancy diffusion. Keep in mind this is happening in solids. It's not in liquids or gases. In a solid, atoms exchange with vacancies. And vacancies could happen because of processing or manufacturing. We cannot have a 100% vacancy-free solids or metals. When we create, manufacture, or process metals or solids, we will have vacancies. And vacancies are locations where we don't have atoms inside our structure. So for example, if you look at this schematic below here, we have this. So each of those circles represent an atom, and the white circle is in a vacancy, which means that we don't have an atom in this location. And this could happen for many reasons, but assuming that we have a vacancy, what's going to happen is that close by atoms will move to this vacancy, and then the vacancy will move to the location of the atom, the original location of the atom. And that's what we mean by vacancy diffusion. And this happens or applies to substitutional impurities atoms, which means that in order to have vacancy diffusion, the space, the vacant space should be something similar to the size of that original atom that is moving to that space. That's why we call it substitutional impurities. Now, the rate of diffusion, the vacancy diffusion depends on three parameters. The first one is the number of vacancies. So if we are creating a material or a solid or a metal, and our process resulted in a large number of vacancies, it means that we're going to have a lot of diffusion, the vacancy diffusion, because of the large number of vacancies. Also, there's something called the activation energy to exchange, which means this is the energy required or needed for an atom to leave its location to another location. Please keep in mind that the activation energy is different from something called excitation energy. Excitation energy happens for electrons inside one atom, where if we expose an atom to radiation, the electrons around the nucleus of the atom will move to an upper orbit. And this electron is excited. And it's an unstable state, and the electron wants to go back to its original place. So if it went back after excitation, it will radiate and will, produce radiation. So this is called excitation energy that happens within an atom. Now, activation energy is something happen for the atom itself. So the atom, in order to move from one location to the other location, that calls activation energy to exchange. And it depends on the elements the material is made of. So some elements have high activation energy, some have low activation energy. So that's a parameter that affects the diffusion, the vacancy diffusion. The third parameter that the vacancy diffusion depends on is the frequency of jumping, of how frequent the atoms will jump from one place to another place. And there are other parameters that affect that. We're not going to go into details about that, but it's worth mentioning that the rate of vacancy diffusion depend on the number of vacancies, the activation energy to exchange, keep in mind this is atoms, not electrons, and also the frequency of jumping. The second mechanism that we'd like to talk about today is something called interstitial diffusion. This happens when smaller atoms can diffuse between larger atoms. To illustrate, you can look at this schematic. So the orange atom is a smaller atom compared to the larger main element that composes the material. So these smaller atoms can move from one location to another location, and that's called interstitial diffusion. Keep in mind, substitutional diffusion, the spaces are assumed to be the same size. Interstitial diffusion, there is one atom that is smaller, way smaller than the other one, and this is the atom that can diffuse. This type of diffusion is way more rapid than vacancy diffusion. Thank you for watching, and until next time.